Hello students, in last session we completed up to example number 14. Let's see the example number 15 here. Example number 15 on your page number 87 in your textbook, a motorboat whose speed is 18 km per hour is still water takes 1 hour more to go 24 km upstream than to return downstream. To the same spot, find the speed of the stream. We would like to find speed of the stream. Let us assume that let us take x kilometer per hour be the speed of the stream. A motorboat whose speed is 18 km per hour in still water, it is given. The speed of motorboat is given. The speed of motorboat is 18 km per hour. A boat goes to upstream and downstream. So that first of all we need to find speed of boat. Speed of boat downstream is equals to, downstream means in same direction, 18 plus x kilometer per hour, and the speed of boat upstream is equals to, upstream means in opposite direction, 18 minus x kilometer per hour. Find the speed of stream. Speed of stream means the value of x. Now in the question given that motorboat whose speed is 18 km per hour in still water takes 1 hour more to go 24 km upstream and then to return downstream. Boat goes to 24 km upstream and return the 24 km downstream. We need to find time taken by boat to travel 24 km upstream is equals to, we know speed is equals to distance upon time, then time is equals to distance upon speed, where the distance is 24 and upon speed, but in upstream, the speed in upstream which is 18 minus x, it is time, then the unit is hour, 24 upon 18 minus x. Same way, time taken by boat to travel again 24 km downstream is equals to 24 upon downstream. The speed of boat in downstream is 18 plus x. Now according to the given condition, according to the given condition, the condition says that a boat takes 1 hour more to go 24 km upstream than to return downstream. As we know how to obtain an equation, here the numerator are same, 18 minus x and 18 plus x. 18 minus x is smaller, then the answer of division is greater. That's why 24 upon 18 minus x minus 24 upon 18 plus x is equals to 1. In the question given that taken 1 hour more. Now we simplify it using LCM. 24 into 18 plus x minus 24 multiply with 18 minus x is equals to 18 minus x, 18 plus x. That's why 24 into 18 as it is plus 24x minus 24 into 18 minus minus plus 24x is equals to 18 minus x and 18 plus x is identity 18 square minus x square. 24x plus 24x is equals to 48x is equals to square of 18 is equals to 324 minus x square. To obtain an equation, we shift both terms right hand side to left hand side. 48x minus 324 plus x square is equals to 0. That's why arrange it, x square plus 48x minus 324 is equals to 0. In our book, this equation is solved by using quadratic formula. But right now, we are applying factorization method. Again, you can also solve it by quadratic formula. If you are going through our textbook, then solve it by using quadratic formula. Suppose we are solving by using quadratic formula, try yourself to do using factorization method. A is equals to 1, B is equals to 48, and C is equals to minus 324. First, find the discriminant b square minus 4ac is equals to square of 48 minus 4. A is 1 and c is minus 324. The square of 48 is obtained here. We multiply 48 by 48. Two three zero four plus 1296. We add them 6 and 3. Here the discriminant is 3600. Using quadratic formula, x is equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a minus, instead of b is equals to 48, plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac 3600 upon 2, instead of a is equals to 1, here the value of a is 1, minus 48 plus or minus square root of 3600 is 60 upon 2. That's why the x is equals to minus 48 plus 60 upon 2, or x is equals to minus 48 minus 60 upon 2. X is equals to 60 minus 48, which is 12 upon 2, and x is equals to minus 108 upon 2, which is minus 54. 2 sixa, x is equals to 6, and the x is equals to minus 54, which is not possible. Here, what is x? Here the x is the speed of stream. The speed of stream is x kilometer per hour, 6 kilometer per hour. Speed of stream is 6 kilometer per hour. Hence, the example number 15 is completed here. Now we discussed exercise 4.3. Let's see the exercise 4.3. Textbook page number 87. Question number 1. Find the roots of following quadratic equation if they exist by the method of completing the square. In the first one, I will explain to try yourself. Find the roots of following equation using the completing the square method. Let us take first of all the first number. The first number is 2x square minus 7x plus 3 is equals to 0. Using the completing the square method, first of all find the third term or last term. Third term is equals to square of middle term upon 4 multiply with the first term. Square of middle term minus 7x square upon 4 multiply first term, which is 2x square. Minus 7x square is 49x square upon 4 to the 8x square. X square, x square cut, and we get 49 upon 8, which is our new last term. Now start from the equation 2x square minus 7x plus 3 is equals to 0. 2x square minus 7x as it is. Instead of 3, first add 49 upon 3, subtract 49 upon 3, plus 3 remains as it is. Take 3 as a LCM, it is 8. Take 8 as a LCM, 8 to the 16x square minus 56x plus 49 minus 49 plus 24 is equals to 0. Take first three terms into a bracket, 16x square minus 56x plus 49. Minus 49 plus 24, 25 is equals to 0. It is the square of 4x minus 7 whole square. Minus 25 is the perfect square number, it is square of 5 is equals to 0. Into first bracket, 4x minus 7 minus 5, in another bracket, 4x minus 7 plus 5 is equals to 0. 4x minus 7 minus 5 minus 12. 4x minus 7 plus 5 minus 2 is equals to 0. Therefore, 4x minus 12 is equals to 0, or 4x minus 2 is equals to 0. That's why 4x is equals to 12 and 4x is equals to 2. By making x as a subject, we get 12 upon 4. 4 threes are x is 3. Same way here, 4x is equals to 2. Then x is equals to 2 upon 4. X is equals to 1 upon 2. Here 3 and 1 upon 2 are the roots or solution of the equation. That's why 3 and 1 upon 2 are roots of given equation. Now we see the next third number. Third number is 4x square plus 4 root 3x plus 3 is equals to 0. First of all, find the third term. See what happened here. Third term is equals to square of middle term upon 4 multiply with first term. 4 fours are 16. Yeah, 4 root 3 x into 4 root 3 x. 4 into 4, x square. X square is cut, 4 is cut. Root 3 into root 3 gives 3. That's why 4x square plus 4 root 3x plus 3 is equals to 0. The term which is third term is 3 already it has. That's why it is a square of 2x plus root 3 whole square is equals to 0. If you are able to do right directly like this, not required to find the third term. That's why 2x plus root 3 in another bracket 2x plus root 3 is equals to 0. On comparing both the brackets with 0, we get 2x is equals to minus root 3 and the x is equals to minus root 3 upon 2. Here also x is equals to minus root 3 upon 2. It is like perfect square trinomial. Therefore, minus root 3 upon 2 and minus root 3 upon 2 are roots of given equation. Hence, from the first number, second and fourth, try yourself. Now see the second number. What is our second number? Find the roots of the quadratic equation given in question 1 above by applying the quadratic formula. The four questions are same as above as per question number 1. From the question number 1, here the first and second is completed. Now we complete second and fourth in question number 2. The second number is 2x square plus x minus 4 is equals to 0. And again, try first and third by yourself using quadratic formula. Here a is equals to 2, b is equals to 1, c is equals to minus 4. First discriminant, b square minus 4ac is equals to square of 1 minus 4, a is 2 and c is minus 4. 1 plus 4 to the 8, 8 4 is 32, which is 33 greater than 0. Therefore, this equation has 2 real distinct root. Using quadratic formula, x is equals to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a minus, instead of b is equals to 1, plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac, which is 33, 2 instead of a is equals to 2, minus 1, plus or minus root 33 upon 2 to the 4, split it, minus 1 plus root 33 upon 4 and minus 1 minus root 33 upon 4. Hence, minus 1 plus root 33 upon 4 and minus 1 minus root 33 upon 4 are roots of given equation. Now we see the next means a fourth number. Fourth number is 2x square plus x plus 4 is equals to 0. Here a is equals to 2, b is equals to 1, c is equals to 4. First find discriminant. 1 square minus 4, a is 2 and c is 4. 1 minus 4 to the 8, here is the 32. Minus 31, which is less than 0. Then what happened here? Here, b square minus 4ac is less than 0. Then, the given equation has no real roots. Real roots are not possible, so that we are not able to finding the real roots of the given equation. The roots doesn't exist. Hence the question number 2 is also completed. Let's see the next question number 3. Question number 3. Find the roots of the following equation. The first equation is given. X minus 1 upon x is equals to 3, where x doesn't equals to 0. First of all, simplify it. X into x, which is x square, minus 1 is equals to 3x. X square minus 3x minus 1 is equals to 0. Here factorization method doesn't possible. We are using quadratic for completing the square. But first choose quadratic formula. A is equals to 1. B is equals to minus 3. And C is equals to minus 1. Discriminant. B square minus 4ac minus 3 square minus 4. A is equals to 1 and C is equals to minus 1. Square of minus 3, 9 plus 4, which is 13 greater than 0. Given equation has 2 distinct roots. Let us find using quadratic formula. Using quadratic formula, x is equals to minus b plus or minus square root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. We substitute all the values here. Is equals to minus, instead of b is minus 3, plus or minus square root of 13 upon 2, instead of a is equals to 1, minus minus plus 3, it is continue, 3 plus or minus root 13 upon 2 ones are 2. Therefore, x is equals to 3 plus root 13 upon 2 and x is equals to 3 minus root 13 upon 2. Therefore, 3 plus root 13 upon 2 and 3 minus root 13 upon 2 are roots of given equation. Now see the next second from the third. Second is 1 upon x plus 4 minus 1 upon x minus 7 is equals to 11 upon 13, where x does not equals to 4 and 7. First of all, take LCM to solve this one. Again, you are not able to write directly, multiply cross it, x minus 7 minus x plus 4 upon x plus 4 into x minus 7, 11 upon 3. Therefore, x minus 7 minus x minus 4. Multiplication of binomial with binomial. X square minus 7x plus 4x minus 28 is equals to 11 upon 3. Plus minus x is cut. Minus 11 upon x square minus 3x minus 28 is equals to 11 upon 30. 11, 11 cut. We cross multiply it. Minus 30 is equals to x square minus 3x minus 28. Therefore, x square minus 3x minus 28 plus 30 is equals to 0. That's why x square minus 3x plus 2 is equals to 0. Here we can apply factorization method completing the square or quadratic formula. The factorization is more convenient. X square factors of 2 whose addition is 3. 2 ones are 2. Minus 2x minus x plus 2 is equals to 0. Pair of first 2 and the pair of last 2. X into bracket x minus 2 minus 1. X minus 2 is equals to 0. Into first bracket x minus 2 in another one x minus 1 is equals to 0. On comparing both the brackets with 0, we get two values of x. X is equals to 2 and here x is equals to 1. Here the x is equals to 2 and the x is equals to 1 are the solution of this equation. Therefore, 2 and 1 are roots of given equation. Hence, up to the question number 3 from our exercise 4.3 is completed. We meet in next session to start our question number 4 and go further. Try yourself, practice well, homework be prepared well in neat and clean handwriting.